how's it going? So I wanted to do this video with the GT100 and my Splawn Supercomp here in four cable method. I did one of these with the GT10, but now since I'm using the GT100, I've had a lot of requests to show my setup. So here it is, let's take a look. Okay, so what is four cable method? Well, it's a way of using a digital modeler in conjunction with a nice amplifier that you're happy with. You like the distortion sound of the amplifier, and of course you need effects. Well, a lot of these digital modelers on the market right now have really good effects, and the amp simulations are pretty good too, but if you're happy with your amp's distortion sound, you don't want to use the digital modeler's amp simulation because it sounds pretty good, but it's not as good as a real amp. It's just not. You know, they've come really close, and I know they have the higher end ones, the Axe FX 2 and Kemper, and you know, those sound really convincing, but for me, I don't know, something about a tube amp, but I like effects. So four cable method is a way to use a digital modeler's effects in conjunction with your tube amp. Now there's some requirements. Your digital modeler has to have an effect send, and your amp has to have a serial effect send, okay? And when you have it hooked up right, you can use the stomps in the digital modeler, like the distortion stomps and you know, compressors or whatever, before the amp, as if would as traditional pedals would hit the front of the amp. And then the time-based effects like delays, reverbs, chorusing, things like that can be placed in the effects loop of the amp. And so there would be after the amp's preamp section. So let's see how to hook all these things up properly. Okay, here's my current pedal board using the Boss GT100. I've also got a Digitech Vocalist 3, which I am a singer, and so I use this for some effects on my vocals, and I also use it for some harmonies. I'm gonna have to show you guys that one time. It works really well. Then I also have a Line 6 M5. I use that for some pitch shifting and not too much stuff, but just a couple of effects. And then I have the Boss FS6 pedals. I'm using that to program on-off effects in the GT100. This is the Splawn Overdrive 1 and Overdrive 2 box here that connects to the amp. So as you can see here, I'm using my GT100 in manual mode. And you can also see my custom labels that I make, where each pedal is assigned. Now, the connections are as follows. Your guitar goes into the input of the GT100. The left mono out of the GT100 goes to the effects return of your amp. The effects send of the GT100 goes to the front of the amp. And then the effects return of the GT100 goes to the effects send of your amp. Now that's how I have it all hooked up. Now, let me go through some of the tones. Say hi to Francis. Don't chew that. Okay, now real quick, I wanted to show you my effects chain on these particular patches, how I have them set up. I'll start at the beginning. These are my amp blocks. You can see that they're off. And the GT100, I'm not using them. First, I have my volume pedal, then the wah, then the comp, and then an OD pedal, just as you would normally on using regular pedals. Then after that, I have a noise gate. Now, here's this S send and return block. Now, everything after this point goes into the effects loop of the amp. So I have, after that, I have a noise gate. I have effects one, which is phaser. Then I have a chorus. Then I have an EQ, which I'm using for my lead boost. And then I have a delay. I forgot effects two is there also. That's flanger. Then EQ boost, delay. And the XL pedal, which I have assigned to one of the pedals. Reverb. So that's my effects chain. So let me go through some of my tones.
Thank you.
Notice how the volume pedal is increasing the delay. Flanger. Phaser. Chorus. Now if I want to go for overdrive, here I go. Lead boost.